Could iron deficiency create a complex 1 disorder? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Alicia says, as a follow-up to my iron deficiency question, how much of an impact does iron deficiency have on mitochondrial function? During the last AMA, you helped me understand some organics test results to deduce a respiratory chain block. Since complex 1 has multiple iron sulfur clusters for electron transport, I'm wondering if there's hope that getting to 30 to 40% transferrin saturation could significantly help my poor mitochondria. That actually makes sense. It's not something that's well studied, but it's totally plausible. I definitely have major energy problems. It's been a long 10 years of fighting to recover first from severe chronic Lyme and then from something weirder, a utility smart meter nearly shutting my body down. Now I'm 35, still far from normal and trying to put Humpty Dumpty back together again. Yeah, I mean, if you're iron deficient and you have blood work that looks like a complex 1 block and you feel like you have an energy metabolism disorder, then while it is possible you have a genetic complex 1 deficiency, it's also possible you have an iron deficiency that is not playing out in your CBC or your thyroid panel that is impacting your energy metabolism. Totally plausible. And I think the best way to test that would be to get your iron levels up to mid-range on serum iron, 30 to 40% iron saturation, transferrin saturation, and see if it helps how you feel. And if you think it's helping you feel better through mitochondrial energy metabolism, rerun the ion panel and see if those markers that made it look like a complex 1 block are resolved. That's the way to approach that. Thank you, Alicia, for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, where I hold monthly private Zoom Q&As for my members. The MasterPass also serves as a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. If you'd like to participate in these Q&As, you can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for 10% lifetime discount. I am currently working full-time on finishing my first book, Vitamins and Minerals 101, How to Get the Nutrients You Need on Any Diet. I will let you know when I have a release date. In the meantime, you can pre-order the book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. Testing Nutritional Status, the Ultimate Cheat Sheet, has been newly released as version 1.3. This is my comprehensive system for managing nutritional status with lab tests, dietary analysis, and comprehensive intake of your signs and symptoms. The new version has a comprehensive guide to interpreting the Genova methylation panel. You can pick up your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. Please consider supporting my work at no extra cost to you by visiting my support page and making a purchase with one of my affiliate links. Some of my most popular affiliates are also listed in the description of this video with links that will give me credit for your purchase. I will try to respond to comments when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.